We have seen the definition of duration. We have seen the types of duration: direct duration, indirect duration, or inverse duration, joint duration, and partial duration. Now, I want to quickly run through the example. This example is on direct duration. We are going to take example on each duration aspect. If y varies directly as x, it's different than saying y is directly proportional to x. If y varies directly as x, the first thing is to interpret what that means. Y varies directly as x. Y varies directly as x. When x is 3, y is 6. Now, it means that y is equal to kx. Now, we can now substitute this into heat. When x is equal to 3, y is equal to 6. It means y is equal to 6, x is equal to 3. That is 3 times 3. 3, 6. Means 6 is equal to 3, k. Then divide both sides. Both sides by 3. We have 6 is equal to 3, k. Divided by 3. Divided by 3. 3 times 3. K is equal to 3 over 1, 3, 2. K is equal to 2. Now, this is the constant. Now that we have the constant, the question says find the laws connecting the variables. They will now put this constant into this interpretation, which means we have y is equal to 2x. This is the law connecting the variables. Now, we can now continue and find y when x is equal to 3. Calculate y when x is equal to 3. To calculate y when x is equal to 3, we substitute for the value of x in the law. It means y is equal to 2 times, what is our x? Our x is 7. 7. Y is equal to 2 times 7, that is 14. This is our y. Then to calculate x when y is 16, the second one, that is question, the third question, to calculate x when y is 16, the same way, look for y and put 16 there. It means 16 is equal to 2x, because x is what we are looking for. Then from here, divide both sides by 2. It means we have 16 divided by 2 equals to 2x divided by 2. 2 equals 2. 2 here, 1. 2 in 8, that is 2 times 8 or 8 times 2, that is 16. It means x is equal to 8. Now, we've solved for y. So for x, and we have seen the law that connects them. This is direct variation. We have seen example on direct variation. Now, I want to take example on indirect variation. Indirect variation. Given that it varies inversely as the square of x, and y is equal to 8 when x is equal to 2. Find the equation connecting y and x. Calculate the value of y when x is equal to 6 and x when y is equal to half. Now, for inverse variation, we have seen the way it's supposed to look like. Now, we need to analyze it first. Given that y varies inversely as the square of x, y, solution, Why? There is inversely one polar. Square of x. X used to power 2. This is square of x. If the question says square root, it means it will be square root of x. This is square root of x. But it's square of x means x used to power 2. Then the next thing is for us to change the proportionality sign and put our constant. It means y is equals to k times 1 over x raised to the power 2, y is the same thing as k times 1 k over x squared. Now we are done with that. The next thing, and y is equals to 8 when x is equals to 2. Now we will place our variable now with their values. Y is 8, write it, 8 is equals to x is 2, we put it k over 2 raised to power 2. Then we look for our k. 8 1 is equals to k. 2 raised to the power 2, that is 2 in 2 places, 2 times 2, that is 4. Now, the next thing we have to do is we have to cross multiply. Cross multiply. Now, as we want to cross multiply, it means we have this multiply this, by this multiply this. K times 1 will give us k, then we have 8 times 4. Now, here it's simple. Some students, they usually have difficulties in multiplication of two numbers and usually give them headache. Now, if we want to work here, they don't have to have any headache. They don't have any headache. 8 in how many places? 4 places. 8. Or if you are not doing that way, 4 in how many places? 8 places. That is multiplication. 8 in 2 places, that will give us 16. 16 in other 2 places will give us 16. If we add it together, this is 12. 2. 1 plus 1. 2. Plus 1. 3. Now, this is working without using calculator or multiplication table. 8 in 3 places. That is, 8 times 1. That one is addition. 8 times 1 is what? 8. 8 times 2. That is 16. Then, if you look at the difference between these two, you discover that 8 times 1, 8. 8 times 2, 16. The addition of 8 to the other 8 gives us what? 16. Then, when we add 8 again to that, that is 8 times 3. It's simple. Just add 8 to this. This is 8. 8, take away 2 from this. 16, 8. Now, this is 8. Take away 2 from this and add it to this. This will give us 10. Remaining what? 4. That is 4. Then add that to this. Give us 24. That is 24. That's all. Then the third one, 8 times 4. The same thing. Add 8 to this. 24 plus 8. Take 2 from here, put it to this. This one is what? 10 plus the remaining 2, that is 12. Then add that one to this. This is 3, that is 32. That's all. Which means you can form a multiplication table yourself. But eventually you are solving and you don't need a calculator, because some students without a calculator they can't work with. Okay, let me check to this. Again, this is multiplication. If you are having it in addition, it means 8 in how many places? 4 places. 8. 8 plus 8, 16. 8 plus 8, 16. Add it together, this is 12. That is 2. Take 1. 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3. That is 32. Okay, now this is just a digression from what we are doing. Now, k is equals to 32. 2, that we cannot get find the equation connecting Y and X. We'll go back to our introduction now. From here, we'll go to this place. From here, we'll get our key. Now, we have our key. Now, take the value of key into the equation here. It means Y is equal to, what's our key? 32 over then our height. Now, this is the equation connecting Y and X. That is the two zeros. You agree with that? Then we can continue. Calculate the value of Y when X is 6 and X when Y is 1 over 2. That's half. Please, you don't have to develop any edit when you are solving this. Now, this is one question, why this is another question. We solve them one after the other. Calculate the value of Y when X is 6. Nice. Let's put it as well. Let's put this one as 1. Now you can write. To find what Y when X is 6. To find Y when X is, take the value of X into the equation, then you work. Now, let's put it. Y is equal to 32 over X is 6, 6 is over 2. Y is equal to 32 over 1. We did something similar to this here. 6 raised to power 2 means 6 in 2 places. 6 times 6. That's what it means. And normally, if you are using multiplication table, 6 times 6 is what? 36. 6 times 6 is 36. But you want to use, if you cannot easily remember, you can use the method I gave the other time. That is 6 in how many places? 2 places. Now, we are working on it. It means 6 times 1, 6, then 6 times 2, you add 6 to this, which means that will give us 12. 6 times 3, you add 6 to 12, and that will give us 18. Are you seeing? It means 6 plus 2, that is 8. Then go to the next one. 6 times 4. You add 6 to these two. It means you're having 18, you're having 6. Take away 2 from this and put it to this. This will give you 10. It remains 4. That is 14. 4. Then add the 1 to this. It will give us 24. Then the next one, 6 times what? 5. You add another 6 to 24. 24, add another 6. This one will give us 10. Then you take the 1 fix to this. This will give us 30. And 30. We have seen this. 6 times 5. We added 6 to this 24 and it gave us 30. Now, 6 times 6 now. It means we are going to add another 6 to this. And we are adding 6. It means 6, then 3. That is 36. Now, if you cannot easily remember this, you can work it in another way. This mathematics world, you need to see different way of solving mathematics. It's not until you use calculator. Your brain should be able to solve without using a calculator. Now, this other aspect that you can do is that you're having 6 times 6. 6 times 6 is the same thing as saying 6 in 6 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 plus 6 give us 2, 12. 12. Another 12. Then we add everything. It's like we are adding all this together. Instead of wasting your time, just add 2, 2, 2. That will give us 6. 111, that will give us 3. That is 56. Okay, now let's quickly work on this. Now, here now, you cannot check. This is 32, this is 36. Now, check. If you are dividing, make sure that you start from the least number that can go in the 2 to make your work easy. What do you do? Let's start. 2 can go in 3. That is 1, remainder 1. Then 2 in 12, that was, that is 6. That is 2 times 6 to give us 12. Let's come to this. 2 in 3, that is 1, remainder 1. Now we continue. How many 2 can we see in 16? That's what we have to check. 2 times 6, 12. 2 times 7, 14. 2 times 8, 16. It means this is 8. Now, we are here. We have 16 over 18. Now, you can still continue and check. What can go in 16 and will still go in 18? Let's still try 2. Now, how many 2 can we see in 16? We have done it here. 2 times 7, 14. 2 times 8, 16. This will give us 8. Now, we come to this place. We have said 2 times 8 is 16. 2 times 9 will give us 18. It means here will be 9. Now, from what we have here now, it means this is 8 over 9. Now that we have 8 over 9, we can now put it back here. Why? It's equal to 8 over 9. But if the question says that you have to change it to decimal, then you have to change it to decimal. But here, if 2 goes in 8, it will give us 4. 2 cannot go in 9. 3 cannot go in 8 without remainder. 3 will go in 9 without remainder, which means you can stop here as the answer for this. Why? When x is equal to 6. Now, the second aspect is to find x when y is equal to half. To find x when y is equal to half. Let's quickly solve that. Yeah? To find x when y is equal to half. It's the same thing with what we have here. It means y is equal to half. 1 over 2 is equal to 22. Over x squared. Then from here again, cos multiply. Cos multiply. Cos multiply. It means this multiply, this multiply. We have x squared times 1 equals x squared. It's equal to 2 times 32. And x squared is equal to 2 times 2. That is 4. 2 times 3. That is 6. Then this gives us 64. Then, anytime you have this, you can do it in two ways. It means x is equal to